Okay, look, I'm not contradicting myself here. This is a video about the idea. It's the idea. It's a devil's advocate point of view. And this is basically me paying my dues. Because yesterday I made a video talking about why I believe Jack Hughes is still the better prospect than Kaapo Kakko. I believe Jack Hughes is still going to go number one. And I kind of got flamed for it in the comments. And I don't think, looking back on that video today, that I actually illustrated my points well enough. Nor do I believe that I got the message across that I really do love Kaapo Kakko as well, too. And I can totally understand why some people would have Kaapo Kakko as a better and more valuable prospect than Jack Hughes. I totally get that. It's just that yesterday my video was a little bit anti-Kakko, and I don't want to say it like that because that sounds really bad, but I will pay my dues and own up to that, so I apologize for that ill-informed kind of video. So today, despite me believing that Jack Hughes is the better prospect and that he'll go number one, I'm making this video here to talk about ways why Kaapo Kakko is indeed better than Jack Hughes. And big shout out to my buddy Grav, Nathan Gravite. He's been killing the YouTube game recently. He made a video basically about this whole thing, about Kakko being better than Hughes. It's just that he has been on the Kakko train for months now, whereas I still technically am on the Hughes train, but I can totally understand everything from a pro-Kakko point of view. Okay, now that sounds really bad. I don't want to make this sound like politics or whatever, so let's just jump straight into it. Kaapo Kakko is a better prospect than Jack Hughes because he is dominating a men's league. He was tearing up TPS, he was leading TPS towards the end of their playoff run, and he was doing that in the league against pro experienced athletes, whereas Jack Hughes was dominating a U18 and NCAA league. So, in terms of the league comparisons, Kaapo Kakko and his impact to his team is pretty much the same as Jack Hughes and the impact to his team. It's just that Kaapo Kakko was playing in a much, much better league. And with this comes the implications of the swap. Imagine if Jack Hughes and Kaapo Kakko switched teams at the beginning of the year. How exactly do you think things would have played out? And the argument for this is not necessarily would Kaapo Kakko have gotten more points than Jack Hughes if he was playing for the USNTDP, but rather, would Jack Hughes have gotten more points than Kaapo Kakko if he was playing for TPS in a men's league as a 17, 18-year-old? And you could definitely argue no. I think it's probably fair to argue no, that Jack Hughes wouldn't have been able to get 38 points in 45 Liga games in his age range this year. And Kaapo Kakko also broke Alexander Barkov's record for most goals as a U18 player, which is absolutely incredible, don't get me wrong. And I mean, Jack Hughes has been breaking records too. Grav actually talked about this in his video. Jack Hughes broke the points record, so he's above Kane, Matthews, Kessel, etc. But Kakko in the Pro Finnish League is now the best U18 goal scorer of all time in that league, so there's that as well. Kaapo Kakko is also better than Jack Hughes because he is way more physically and mentally mature than Hughes. And by mentally, I mean the fact that Kaapo Kakko was able to play such a complete game at all ends of the ice, and where some people kind of question the defensive ability from Jack Hughes once in a while, that's never the case with Kakko. Kakko is a reliable penalty killer, he's a reliable two-way guy, on top of being able to put up the points that he does. Meanwhile, Jack Hughes, whose game relies with his speed, is more offensively oriented and less of a two-way defensive presence than Kaapo Kakko is. Add to this the literal physical maturity that Kaapo Kakko has over Jack Hughes, as Kaapo Kakko is a 6'2", 190-pound winger. Jack Hughes, the undersized centerman, doesn't have the same ability as Kaapo Kakko has to drive the play with his body and to power through guys. Kaapo Kakko is more physically mature and he uses his body to the best of his ability, which is something that in a lot of cases Jack Hughes literally cannot do. Kaapo Kakko has the edge over Jack Hughes at being a player who's valuable everywhere and not just breaking the puck in and doing things in the offensive zone. Don't get me wrong, I personally believe that Jack Hughes is a little bit better in terms of offensive creativity, flexibility, and ambition. But Kaapo Kakko is no slouch, for sure. Kaapo Kakko is also better than Jack Hughes because he is more NHL-ready, meaning that he will make a more prominent impact for longer than Jack Hughes will at the NHL level. Kaapo Kakko is a guy who could step into the NHL tomorrow, either with the New Jersey Devils or the New York Rangers, and probably put up 50 to 60 points next season. He's going to be a guy who competes for the Calder. Meanwhile, Jack Hughes, there's a little bit of an uncertainty as to how he will translate right away. Physical maturity levels and overall a general concern as to how Hughes will play against the next level of competition. These are things that Kaapo Kakko does not have, putting him above Jack Hughes. Kaapo Kakko is also better than Jack Hughes because he can play center too. Kaapo Kakko played a good amount of this season with the TPS Turku as a center. He was playing with Petrus Palmu on his wing, and he was doing amazingly well. Kaapo Kakko is a guy who doesn't necessarily have the winger factor holding him back. Because Jack Hughes is a natural center, he's projected to go higher. But Kaapo Kakko can play center too. And despite being a guy who primarily plays on the wing, he can show his center abilities as well. And he has shown that throughout the year. So giving the center argument to Jack Hughes isn't necessarily 100% all thought out as it seems to be, because Kaapo Kakko can do that as well. Sure, he's a natural winger, but he can impact the game as well in Jack's position. And finally, Kaapo Kakko is better than Jack Hughes because he's proving it. The World Championships here are basically the only real form of head-to-head competition that's actually kind of laid out in a neat way. The World Juniors, nah, I'm not gonna count that. Jack Hughes was injured for a lot of the games, and Team USA, you know, they still did their thing even without Jack Hughes. But at the World Championships this year, Kaapo Kakko is doing tremendously well. And yesterday, when I made my video about Hughes versus Kakko, Kaapo Kakko got himself a goal, so he's still dominating things. And at 7 points in 4 games played, 6 of them being goals, and fantastic goals, by the way, he's totally making a case for being better than Jack Hughes, especially since Jack Hughes is only at 0 points. And that's literally the worst that he could do in the 4 games that he has played, which certainly isn't a good look for a guy looking to go first overall against the guy who's totally dominating the tournament right now. So in conclusion, there are many, many factors that I personally agree with that lead to Kaapo Kakko being better than Jack Hughes. And I totally acknowledge that. Kaapo Kakko is the better player today, hands down. If they were in the NHL today, Kakko would be better, and that is a fact. That is how things work out right now. Kaapo Kakko is just better. For me personally, I see the potential in Hughes as higher than the potential of Kaapo Kakko. But that's not a point that I'm able to use in an argument against Kaapo Kakko. It's just its potential. You can't really talk about that. You can't dispute that because that's not a fact. That's not something that you can say is definite, and everyone's gonna have a different idea of that. It's just that my idea paints Jack Hughes as a better prospect than Kaapo Kakko, which is why I said in my video yesterday, Kakko is the better player, but Hughes is a better prospect because Hughes has more potential in my eyes. But there's people who are going to disagree with that, which is fine. But for the facts and what you can prove, what you can dispute, and what you can say is probably a general consensus, Kaapo Kakko is way better than Jack Hughes is today. Now, 10 years from now, who knows? Grav had a different opinion. He said that Kaapo Kakko probably has the same potential as Jack Hughes, and I've been seeing a lot of people who believe that Kaapo Kakko could definitely be the better player than Jack Hughes 10 years down the line. I don't see it like that, but if it did happen like that, then hey man, I'm good with surprises, I like being wrong, that's great. Kaapo Kakko can be the best player on planet Earth, and that would be amazing. But for me, I would see the potential in Jack Hughes as being more valuable than that of what Kaapo Kakko brings later down the line. Now, I say all that despite the ideas that I did present, despite the truths that I did say here that Kaapo Kakko is just better than Hughes today. But I believe Hughes is still the better prospect, which is why I made this video to clear things up, giving all my love and praise to Kaapo Kakko, because I love the guy too. Seriously, they're both gonna be amazing, they're both gonna be elites, probably gonna be both franchise too? So there's that. Obviously they're not McDavid, but Jack Hughes kind of plays the game kind of like McDavid in terms of how he drives the game and everything with his speed. So I'm sitting here giving all my love to Kaapo Kakko because I acknowledge that he has so many great qualities as a prospect, and there's a really good argument to be made as to why he should be drafted first overall. Now, with that being said, I still think Hughes is going first, but Kaapo Kakko would be an amazing first overall pick too. They've both broken records, they're both super dominant in their leagues, but Kakko is better. And you can't really argue with that. Now, I think that kind of cleared my name for a little bit. I think I kind of got the points across that I still do love Kaapo Kakko, despite believing that Hughes is the better prospect and Hughes will go number one, but I digress. Hope you enjoyed this video. Social Lab shows us on gaming. And bye.